Nigerian youth have taken to social media to air their grievances on the abuse, harassment and violation of human rights by men of the Special Anti-Robbery Squad, SARS, of the police, also known as SARS. They demanded that the police unit be dismantled while recounting their ordeal in the hands of the operatives. Ayobami Pasha, who has been monitoring the campaign, went to town and filed in the report.
When kidnapped Kingpin Evans was arrested recently, he was conveyed by the SARS team to the Lagos State Police Command headquarters. The policemen rejoice in the aftermath of the capture of what many may see as a big fish. This is one of the few occasions that Lagos residents hail SARS operatives for doing what they are paid to do, curbing the menace of armed robbery and kidnapping in the society. But now, many Nigerians, especially the youth, want the police authorities to scrap the squad, following series of allegations of violation of rights, brutality and extrajudicial killings. The campaign has gone viral on Twitter, with many recounting their hoodie while also sharing videos of SARS operatives in action. It was difficult getting victims to share their hoodie on camera, even after assurances of anonymity were made. This, they say, is as a result of fears of retribution from police team, which elicits so much fear on one hand and animosity on the other hand. But on the streets are what seems like a vocal minority who are against the End SARS campaign. They see the police as a reflection of the wider Nigerian society.
The group, at least their work is good anyway, anti-robbery squad, but at least they should do it the way it's supposed to. Not you harassing innocent people. Like this road now, I don't think there's any armed robber on this road. Why must they be harassing people? Because they know that these young boys, they normally come to buy goods from other shops.
We have a state CID that operate before. So let can then call back again in a full force. Because for me, I don't like the way they operate. The way they harass people, the way they do on the checkpoint is very bad. So if you may ask me, I say I don't want them.
Like of the average Nigerian. The average Nigerian is afraid of SARS more than he's afraid of the armed robber. And that should not be the case. We should be more afraid of the man who comes to your house at night than the one who comes to your house in the daytime with a gun and wearing one polo with a black shirt or whatever color it is that they choose to wear. So scrapping SARS may not be the solution, but reforming the system might be better.
For another group of Lagos residents, SARS operatives need more enlightenment to know that young people owning fancy mobile phones and laptops are not necessarily fosters or armed robbers.
SARS has been, I read the paper the first day, SARS has been existing before 1980. It's a good arm of police unit. They should be reformed and sensitized. They should employ people with sound, intelligent, and they should test them before they give them guns.
It should be, if it's scrapped, we are going to leave a lot of people unemployed. What we need to do is educate these people and tell them that that we should try and help each other, that you're making life difficult. You know, there are 10-year-olds in India that are developing applications. Why? Because they have access to it. In Estonia, internet is a fundamental human right. But here, I'm trying to make a payment, and the network, no, they go. I'm trying to pay for Wi-Fi, it's not going. How can I do e-courses? There are free courses online on cyber security, database management, web production. Boys won't learn them. They want to develop apps. They have ideas. But SARS go come.
Inspector General of Police Ibrahim Idris once stated that SARS should be an advocate of new change mantra, as the agency has a great role to play in nation security. But the question remains, will the voice of the youth be heard? Will the Special Anti-Robbery Squad be scrapped or reformed? Ayobami Opache, Core TV News, Lagos.